Nice. Level 8. 55 hit points and power points. Spell learning points, 38. Training points, 18. And Edgel. We get another one. Dun, dun, dun. 53 hit points. That's awesome. That, however, is not awesome. Does another bandit note? Why do they all have the same note? We've already went past the teleporters, though. Oh, no. Left, right, center, right. Chest. Please contain something valuable, something powerful to take down another bandit leader in case we run into them. We still have to go through this door. And we have to try to get out of here as well. So it leveled me up. Oh, good. Not like Amber Star. I don't know if I noticed this before, but with Amber Star, you would level up your points. You'd get a new maximum. Like, say, my points were used to be 40. My life points here. So if I leveled up, and you wouldn't get this much, but if you got 55 was your new maximum, you'd still be at 40, and your max would be 55. Here, it's brought me up to the max, so you would otherwise have looked like you were injured. But like, no, you were at your previous full hit points. That makes any sense. So I'm gonna save over my B slot. B slot, baby! And of course, I will use a lockpick. And unlocked. Healing potion 3 and 4. Cure poison, spell points 3, and intelligence potion. Well, we need all this stuff. Definitely. And 998 gold. We're gonna have to drop some more stuff, aren't we? Yes, we are. I don't want to drop the magical arrows, though. Let's drop these. Let's... I can also store stuff in the chest, but I can't imagine coming back here. Oh, I don't have the drop here. I don't. Stand by, chest. We will be right with you. Short bow. I'm probably gonna have to drop the short bow. Mm. 39. Yeah, I'm gonna have to drop some more leathers. I wonder what gives you more, a short bow or leathers? So we might be able to withstand him now. We'll just use a lot of those potions. I'm talking about if we come across another bandit leader. I also have a short sword. Just, I want to sell some of this stuff, you know? That's a lot, look at that. Those arrows weigh that much? I mean, I know there's a lot of them, but... Just arranging here. I am not dropping the target bow. That's a pretty powerful bow. Take all my food? I don't know what else to do. There you go. Spell points. Don't really need that. Cure poison, you can have that, because I have a bunch. Healing potion 4. I'm gonna give some, him some, try to anyway. Take them for now. Damn, we can't take all the gold. We are overladen. Overladen. I'm dropping the short bow then. How much is... 800 grams. I don't think it's gonna help that much. I mean, true, we can sell the short bow, so we're selling... We're dropping the short bow in order to pick up more money, but we could also sell the short bow for money. So I don't know which is the better answer. I'm not... wait. Hold up. Hold up. I can't drop from that screen. Yeah, this is heavier. Bye, money. It's just, I want him to be able to take some of these healing potions. In case I need to be healed. Potion 4, that's awesome. There we go. All in order, how satisfying. He's got some cure poison. Thank you. And so we might be able to withstand one of these bandit chiefs now. Without using the fireball was the only thing that was saving us. Okay, now we can pick up the money. I hate leaving money there, you understand. Oh, how did I get up a 22? Oh, I gave him all the rations, didn't I? Got all the money. Left 8 rations in there. Now, the one good thing is they're probably going to use some of these potions just to survive the next battle if there's a chief. No. Okay, so we've been in these two rooms. We have not been through there. We have not been through there. So I kind of want to hit that. So this is that big room. So make a right out of here and go more or less ahead and hit the left door. We have not been here, correct? Apparently I have not explored this area. Alright, you satisfied now? Joy! Hope it's just regular guys. It is. Right. Battle you can survive is always a good one. Yeah, I don't think we've hit anyone yet. I'm gonna focus on... I'm already hitting that guy. Okay, that's good. I can't wait to train up our attack. Poof! Look at that! I took him out before you, Agile. Should be embarrassed. I'm just used to clicking that. I am connecting a lot more. Maybe something happens at 60. Maybe it's the round numbers like that. I assumed it was just a percentage. Look at that. I've got rid of both of them. Agile's still working on his one opponent. Agile, that's embarrassing for you. There you go. Alright, we can't pick up any of this stuff. Luckily, we got the gold. Huh. Alright, we can't do anything with that, apparently. Looks like someone buried the hatchet. Oh. You're just waiting for us. He's just standing there. That's fine. I prefer to look around a little bit. Making sure you're still there. Love what you've done with the place. The decor is marvelous. Alright, there's a chest. He's still waiting over there. Shall we see what's in the chest? We got a robe, leather, clothes, a steel helm, a horned helm, chainmail shirt, sandals, I don't care about those. A buckler, a round shield, a small shield, knife, a whip, a flail. These are give you a good amount of money. I wonder if you can come back here, because we can't carry all this stuff. His sun helmet. Is a plus 3. Steel helm is plus 4, but doesn't have that magic effect. I don't know if you need to be wearing it though. Oh, this inflicts damage and shield. Can I wear this? Oh. Adventure. Ironclad leather. Oh, I have to take it off first. Wait a second. Armor's 13 with it on. The chest is full. And we are too, that's the problem. Because none of us can pick that up. Wish you could stack leathers. Is there anything stackable in the chest? It doesn't seem so. A longbow there too. Alright, I don't know, we'll come back to this. I hope. I would love to come back here and buy and sell some of this stuff, keep some of this stuff. Anything else of note? That's the door we came through. What's this? Cage to hold a very big canary. I know, it's a person would be in there. No description or anything inside that we can do anything with. Got a chain on the wall over there. What is this on the wall here? Let's keep looking at him. He's not moving. Oh, just various chains and such. Alright. Hello? These guys don't move, though. And they're gonna move now. I'm gonna use up all the potions. Just to survive the bandit chief. Does anything like the other bandit chief will probably attack Edgel, who's already wearing chainmail. Otherwise, I'd reload and take the chainmail. I'd put gold or rations in there to lower our weight or item limit. Let's just try to kill these guys as quickly as possible so we can get through this. 1 point. Okay, not bad. He is wearing the boots now, which means he might get deflected more often. Oh. You know what? That's stupid. No. Sorry, guys. I forgot to put that back on. And that could be the difference between life and death here. I wonder how much. Plus 8. Plus 7. I mean, is like really gonna make that much of a big of a difference? Yeah, let's stride forward. I'm wearing it now. In case we die and I reload, I might forget to put it on. I mean, is he guarding something? I mean, evidently that's the end, though. Maybe he's guarding the second button that we have to press. The fact that he's just standing there, not doing anything. Was a skeleton chained up, but maybe that skeleton has something valuable. Alright, so now might not be as lucky with the bandits' attacks this time. I don't know. We'll find out. Ah, told ya! Not as lucky. Still at 36. Should I start healing already? I guess. A healing potion 2. Attacking me now. There you go. Bandit's dagger was broken. making sure none of our stuff is broken. Okay, man, let's take the bandit down. He's one of them. I wonder how much the healing potion 4 gives you back. 7, bye-bye. Another bandit's dagger broken. No damage. 10 points. Boom. Six points. It's okay. One of them's backing up. He's at 33. I'm gonna move him around though because we can't advance. I'd like to heal him, but... leather was broken. 6 points. Okay, now we can advance. And advance again. I will attack him. If I had known, I would not have moved Agile. Three points. It's okay, he can go away. We will now kill you. His short bow is broken. Making sure none of our stuff is broken. I'm paranoid about missing a message like that. The last horseshoe might be behind him, you never know. Now kill your leader, or one of them. One of the 5 leaders you have. Three points. 5 points. My longsword is broken. We have a replacement, though. I can deal with that. Just don't break another one. It's our last one. Actually, tell you the truth, I'm not going to attack this round. I'm going to heal him. Because he's at 20. Healing potion 3. I realize I have 4, but that'd probably be a waste at this point. Ten points. Damn. Did you say something is broken? No. I think it's one of his things are broken. Six points on Agile, 7 points. The other guy's just moving up back and forth. 1 point. Okay, the other guy's out of the picture. Finally. He was getting annoying with that. 2 points. Five points on Agile. 4 points on the bandit leader, and another 2 from me. He's at 24. I'm gonna wait. upgrading. We're all failing. Whiff, whiff, whiff. 1 point. 2 points. Come on. 4 points. Damn, how many points does this guy have? Well, we've only defeated them. 6 points, that's no good. We've only defeated them with fireballs, not with conventional methods. Oh, 14 points. He's at 30 now. Okay, we will resume attack. Oh, he healed himself? I guess so. I thought I was doing it. I know, we're rearranging here. It'd be all for naught if we don't win this fight. Of points. 5, 4. I hate using all these. But I hate dying more. 6 points. And we also did 6. Okay, Edgel now at 38. Points on Agile 7. Poof! Got him. Few magical arrows. He broke his, what do you call it? Here's another bandit note. He broke his thing, but he still had more arrows. Where are the horseshoes? I haven't stepped over here, so the map didn't finish up. Alright, the only thing I can think of is horseshoes through there. I had no idea. You fought this bandit chief. I figured that was it. He was the bandit chief. Oh no, there are quite a few of them, and we have to fight more of them. So we're headed down here. I figured that guy was guarding something. He wasn't moving. Coming just an error with the AI. Oh, that's the way back. I assume we're facing south? Place is full of bats. Heading right then. Wait, not here though. It's that door, isn't it? Hold up. Let me just make sure I'm at the right place. Yep. Another lockpick. Okay. An old man suddenly appears from nowhere in the room. He first looks at you in silence, but then he says in a sonorous voice, "Hold on. My name is Nagir, and I am the master of the bandits. You have killed most of my people, and now I only have a handful of helpers left. So I have a suggestion for you. You can either have one last very fierce battle, or I promise you I will leave Spannenberg in peace and also train you in the skill of critical hits. The choice is yours. Do you want to make peace?" "Yes." "A wise decision, saving victims on both sides. Come in and let us talk about it." "Will you also give me the last horseshoe?" I wonder what the battle would have been like, but we probably wouldn't have survived it. "You see an old man ahead, but he does not give the impression of being weak and fragile. On the contrary, he moves with great agility." I saw the way he backed up there. Poke. Nagir, 76 years old. Level 15 thief. "Thank you again for accepting my proposal. Please take this letter to Baron George of Spannenberg. I hope he will also accept my offer. And before I forget, please take this key. It fits the chest in my bedroom. You'll find some stolen items from Spannenberg in the chest." His bedroom. Is that the one we opened? Or another one? "Please return them to their rightful owners." Nagir's letter and Nagir's key.